Can Parkinson's disease start in the gut? New science on the microbiome connection has told us that it is possible that Parkinson's disease starts in the gut. There are some abnormal proteins, I'll call them alpha-syn proteins, that first appear in the gut microbiome long before the motor symptoms of Parkinson's disease start. In this video, I'm going to explore a groundbreaking research study and give you my interpretation of the study. I'll link to the original study article in the description. Thank you for stopping by my channel. I'm so glad to see you. Please remember to subscribe and hit the notifications so that you'll be informed of future videos. Remember that information on my channel is for information and educational purposes only. I'm not establishing a patient-provider relationship. Please consult your own medical team if you have questions about medications or lifestyle changes. So today I'm going to describe the topic, define the study article design and some of the variables they looked at, discuss the author's findings and their conclusions, and then as always, I give you my tips and takeaways at the end. So the topic is the gut microbiome. There is so much emerging research on this topic. It seems that in the gut, there is the formation of some abnormal proteins called alpha-syn proteins. They first appear in the gut, affecting the nerves that come from the intestinal tract. They also invade the walls of the intestine and can spread to the brain via the vagus nerve. Sometimes changes in your gut microbiota due to toxins or environmental exposures or viruses can lead to the production of these abnormal proteins. Research is really unsure of why these proteins form in some people and what the events are that cause them to form. The sensory cells in the gut lining are known as entero, which whenever you see that term, entero, it means the gut, endocrine cells. We know that the gut is an endocrine organ and secretes hormones, just like other endocrine organs in our body, including, for example, the thyroid. We know that these EECs, enteroendocrine cells, contain this abnormal alpha-syn protein. This research evidence provides a connection between the gut and the brain. Interestingly, patients who have undergone a vagotomy or a dissection of the vagus nerve for one condition or another, who also have a collection of these abnormal proteins in the gut, it appears that those proteins don't show up in the brain. Thus, research is pointing to the fact that these abnormal proteins travel to the brain via the vagus nerve. So this is from the research article, and I think it was a nice graphic illustration of how the alpha-syn proteins end up in the brain. Alpha-syn proteins are some of the building blocks of what we call Lewy bodies. Lewy bodies are found in the substantia nigra of patients with Parkinson's disease. So it starts in the gut because of some injury or environmental toxin or some sort of exposure or some dysbiosis in the gut microbiota. We're really not sure of the cause. But then they send these seeds, if you will, up the vagus nerve. The seeds, if you will, end up in the substantia nigra of the brain, and they start to aggregate or collect together and grow. And this appears to be the origin of the Lewy body pathology that we see in Parkinson's disease. It's noted that this process can go on for decades before anyone ever has any symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Research has been looking for a cause. If we can intervene in these early, early stages, is it possible that we can prevent even the creation of the Lewy bodies in the brain and thus perhaps prevent Parkinson's disease? Well, this is a huge area of research right now. So we know that what happens with these alpha-syn proteins leading to Lewy bodies is they begin to misfold. They deform, if you will. We know also that the neurons connect with these enteroendocrine cell neurons from the gut lining. When we dissect the Lewy bodies, we find the alpha-syn proteins. They end up within the cell bodies of neurons, and then they affect the axons or dendrites. Remember, these are the connections between your neurons and play a huge role in the conductivity of electrical impulses in the brain, in the neurons themselves. There is some research that points to exposures to environmental toxins or pesticides, which may have a causative property for the creation of these alpha-syn proteins in the gut lining. It's also evident in research that 30%, and I would say or more, of patients with Parkinson's suffer some gastrointestinal symptoms, again, decades before they ever have problems with Parkinson's symptoms. The most common GI complaints are intermittent nausea, vomiting, and of course, constipation is a huge GI symptom before you develop Parkinson's and then afterwards. These symptoms point to problems with motility disturbance. So our GI systems work by moving food substances and digestive juices through the system. This is called motility. Our stomach has a form of motility. And then, of course, our small and large intestines function mainly with moving these substances through. So we know that the motility in our GI system can be a major problem when you have not only these alpha-syn proteins or problems with your gut microbiota, but also once you're diagnosed with Parkinson's. So this research leads to some potential ideas for treatment. Is it possible to treat people with Parkinson's with some nutritional therapies that modify the gut microbiome to improve symptoms and possibly limit the disease progression? This is the foundation of the research that I conduct. Experimental research shows that it's the microbes themselves that can affect the progression of this alpha-syn protein, that if you have certain microbes that can be protective in the gut, perhaps they can reduce the incidence of this protein or reduce this protein's aggregation. Remember, that term is the gathering or collection of these proteins, or potentially prevent this protein from even traveling up the vagus nerve. Some of the things you can do to improve your gut microbiota include the use of high fiber nutritional components. Some of these that we see in a ketogenic approach are things like asparagus and greens such as spinach and kale, dandelion greens, onions and shallots, leeks, garlic, artichokes, some high fiber fruits like berries, or some fermented foods like fermented pickles, sauerkraut, and fermented dairy. Check out my channel for a video on probiotics and the gut microbiome. In that video, I actually show you how to make your own homemade probiotic fermented dairy. So there's a lot of emerging research on what we call targeted psychobiotics. That is targeted probiotics that have a psychoactive component, can actually influence the brain. One of these that is receiving a lot of research attention is L. plantarum, Lactobacillus plantarum. Check out my research review where I review a study that investigated L. plantarum in Parkinson's disease. So my practical applications are going to look very familiar if you've watched others of my videos on my channel. An easy place to start is to eliminate all processed foods. Now, what are those? Well, Dr. Ben Bickman would call them foods that are in boxes and bags with barcodes. If you shop the perimeter of your grocery store, you will see whole foods in their most natural forms for the most part. That is, you go in the grocery store and you head to the produce aisle and then the meat and fish and chicken department, the dairy department, the eggs department, the seafood department, and then out the door you go. Focus on those healthy fats that feed your microbiome. These include coconut oil, grass-fed butter, avocado oil, olive oil, beef tallow, and lard. Reduce the simple carbohydrates that you know raise your blood sugar. Remember, everyone has their own individual carbohydrate tolerance. Try an elimination diet, which means move towards a carnivore type one meal a day dietary pattern. Begin by eliminating everything in your diet except for ruminant, meats, bone broth, water, and healthy fats. You can have some herbal teas. This is the ultimate elimination diet. And I would suggest trying it for 2 to 3 weeks. See how you feel. And then gradually add back one food source at a time and see what your gastrointestinal symptoms are like. Keep your fats high in your diet and your proteins moderate, 15 to 25% of your daily calories. How are you going to know what your individual carbohydrate tolerance is? Well, you've heard me before. If you're testing your glucose and ketones every morning, you'll know what your body is feeling about the level of carbohydrates you are consuming. Drink a lot of water with some lemon juice in it. You may also need to add some salt. Lemon juice really helps the stomach if you're having issues of GERD or reflux symptoms or lots of indigestion. Coffee is fine, herbal teas, but no sodas or alcohol or sugary juices. Investigate the use of probiotics and fermented foods like kefir, fermented dairy, sauerkraut, fermented pickles. Check out Dr. William Davis's book called Super Gut. It's a wonderful resource on the gut microbiome and how to fix some of these gastrointestinal issues. Avoid antibiotics when you can. Limit your use of NSAIDs like ibuprofen and Aleve. And omit any GERD medications. These are like omeprazole, Nexium, Prilosec, Prevacid. NSAIDs and these GERD medications truly alter the nature of your gut microbiome. And it's researched that these items actually kill off the protective microbiota. And you don't want to do that. This is the reference to the little article that I reviewed on Parkinson's disease and its origins in the gut. I'll link the study article below so that you can read it for yourself. Remember that these research reviews are just my interpretation of this research, but I want you to research these articles yourself. Thank you for stopping by for another one of my research reviews. This one was about the origins of Parkinson's disease and the possibility that Parkinson's actually starts in the gut. Check out my other research videos and my other videos on various applications for health and metabolic health conditions. I'll see you in the next video.